Welcome to Prophetic Rewind. This week, I have more of my dad doing personal prophecies. And this time, he was in Denver, Colorado, and it was 1996. And it is an astounding, amazing night. And I just had to share it with you. The way that God would speak through him and touch personal lives is something that you haven't really seen too much of on the den and on the broadcast. But it's something I really felt you needed to see. And there's a beautiful message in this, and I know it's going to touch you and bless you and amaze you. So let's watch.
So stand and let's take somebody by the hand. Don't you love it when God tells us stuff? Together now, let's pray this prayer. Lord, I receive the blessing for my family. And now, Lord, I embrace your promise for my city, for my state, for my country. Take my heart. Take my heart of gold. Take my tear to hold. Take my prayer and use it for the city. In Jesus' name. Lift your hands and begin to praise him. Lift your hands and begin to praise him. Lord, we release every human being in this building. Lord, I pray you give them the power to bring under subjection the forces that have tantalized them, the forces that have tormented them, the forces that have lied to you. Cancer is leaving the body right now. There is a cancer that has tormented somebody that's leaving your body. A prostrate gland is being healed by the Holy Spirit right now. God is doing a miracle in the colon right now. Cancer is being broken over Jill. God is touching Anita again. I get your name. God says, I'm going to give you prosperity like you've never had before. Keep praying, everybody. Billy, where's Billy? Wave your hand, Billy. Billy, where is Billy? Billy, stand over there, stand up here. Where is it? Is Billy at the back? Where's Billy at the back? Where's Billy at the back? Come on, where's the Billy? Billy, William, come on, where are you? Wave your hand. There's another one in this building, I know it. Come on, there's gotta be. God wouldn't have said it, otherwise it's gotta be you. Is somebody praying for that person? It's you then. Why do I see a force of evil that has tormented your bloodline? That's tormented your family, that has come through every generation and would dare to visit you and give you the same. You're not Billy. God is touching somebody else at this very moment. Come on, you pray. God is destroying the curse of the bloodline and the curse that has endeavored to break you down. To make you fall, God says, no, not at all. I'm going to build you up and break the curse of a generation of addicts. God is doing it tonight by His Spirit. Everybody lift your hands up and let's pray against this thing right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus, believe your father, stepfather, what is wrong with him? Where is he right now? Listen, lift up your hands and pray. Everybody pray. Father, right now, we loose this man. We loose the family from an unclean spirit. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Loose him! Loose him! Your stepfather has had a following of curses. I see wrecks and accidents in your family. Mental torment is being broken right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Keep praying, everybody. He was hurt at work. Has he had a series of accidents before this, do you know? Right. And he's had surgery for this. He's disabled. He cannot walk correctly. That's right. Lift up your hands. God's going to heal his body. Because he said that about Billy. He's Billy. Okay, you're not Billy. Okay. You, your brother, your younger brother, at this very moment, he's being touched by the Holy Spirit. He needs a miracle. His heart is crying. How old is your younger brother? Where does he work? Is it a pancake place or something? Is it a pancake place? Where does he work? A restaurant? Restaurant. God is touching. Is he in the restaurant right now? God's touching him in the restaurant right now. Right now, is he serving? God is touching him. He's putting his spirit upon him. He's going to come out of this thing by November. And the Lord says, the miracle is beginning to happen in your stepfather's spine. Right now, loose him in the name of Jesus. It's done. Loose, loose, loose. Let the curse be broken. It's done. It's done. It's done. Come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, give them all a shout of praise. Come on, get God to it. Some of you are praying for sons. Some of you are praying for your sons. Some of you praying, four people praying for their sons. That lady at the back, the African-American lady, come here quickly. God's going to touch your son in a big way. I'm talking big way, man. Keep praying. There's another woman praying for her son. It's a woman. George. Come quickly, honey. God's going to do a miracle thing. Come quickly. Everybody looks at her and pray. Is somebody dying in your family? Somebody died in the family just recently. Yes. Come and keep praying. The spirit of death is still hovering. Your grandmother just died recently? Yes, just recently. Okay. She was saved, yes. Just before she died, something very special happened. Michelle, a little girl. Michelle is your daughter. I saw Michelle praying. How old is she? 14. She is going to pray against the spirit of death. And this one feels cold and so powerful. I see Michelle prophesying. She's a prophetess to this generation. Satan won't kill her. He won't disappoint. God won't let her be disappointed. Friends will not influence her. She'll influence friends. You know why? Michelle is a prophetess of the Lord. That's why. Hallelujah. God says she will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. She will cast out demons. She will raise the dead. You know why? Because God said, you may not even know this, but she prayed. And God said when she prayed, something happened to that grandmother. Something happened as she was dying. And the word of the Lord came into her heart that she died. God said, Michelle has a prophetic anointing to raise the dead. God said, that's going to happen mightily. The next move from Michelle to Michael. For God says, God has taken him. Listen to this. Taken him. Where's Michael right now? He's right. Now God, how old is Michael?
10.
Huh? Listen to that. Don't tell me that God is touching him right now. I actually saw Texas. I saw him in Texas. I saw the fire of God in Houston, in his spirit. And God says, Michael is going to be a mighty warrior. Will be prosperous. He will not ever fall to his feet, but he'll be raised up with finances in his hands. He will have finance in his hands. He will have money. God says, right now, the powers of darkness that have tried to torment your family are being dealt with. There are people in Houston, Texas right now that God is touching. God is changing. Don't worry, woman. You prayed. Michelle and Michael will raise the dead, but cast out demons, cleanse the leper, do some miracles. They will even raise up those that have fallen down to the ground. You know why? Because God has anointed your family as an apostolic prophetic anointing upon them because you pray, says the Lord. Let's give the Lord a shout of victory. Come on. Michelle will raise the dead. She'll cast out demons. Michelle will raise the dead, and she'll cast out demons. Michelle will raise the dead, and she'll cast out demons. Michelle will raise the dead, and she'll cast out demons. I want you right now to put your son and your daughter's name where we've just sung. We're going to prophesy that our children are going to do it. Are you ready? Let's go. Put the name of your child. If you don't have a child, your brother, your sister, your mother, your father, whatever, your grandmother, your grandfather, and your cousin, your niece, your nephew, whatever you feel, say it right now. Tell Michelle to raise the dead and she cast out. Now say it then.
Michelle
raise the dead and go cast out. Say the name. George, is he bound? God was his wife. Where is his wife right now? I'm sorry, I can't. Your daughter? Why do I feel that there is something not right there? She's being smothered, not physically, but emotionally. How many children does she have? Three children. She's not pregnant, is she? There's a problem. Let me tell you something right now. The forces of darkness are trying to intimidate her through this mouth, through that person. I believe that God wants to set George free. God wants to set him free, and tonight is his night. That your son-in-law, God says, I'm going to swing him around. He's going to walk the other way. I see him on his knees, praying and pleading with God. Why? Because Satan has literally tormented him, and it's abusive to your daughter. And God said that abusive spirit is being dealt a severe blow tonight. George, we speak to the spiritual wickedness that came through the father, through the bloodline. We release you from that. Andrea? Which one is Andrea? That's your daughter. God said, when she was born, I elected her, set my hand upon her. Satan didn't want her to breathe. That Satan didn't want her to have the lungs that she had. But God said, I gave her everything that it took to bring her to this place. And her children are going to prophesy what she couldn't prophesy. Her children will do what she didn't do because she will impart them with God's power, says the Lord.
Go ahead.
joy to the Lord, my friends. It always excites. It always ignites. It always delights the word of the Lord. Always ignites, always excites, always delights. It does. Constantly the word of the Lord ignites, excites, and delights. Your brother's in prison right now. Is your brother in prison right now? In jail or jail prison? To me, it doesn't make a difference. I'm from South Africa. Same thing. As long as he's bars, he's in jail or prison. I don't know. In America, you've got this evaluation for every little thing. That's not prison and jail. That's right. He's there right now. There's an accuser sitting in his ear. He was beaten, and I see a bruise and a scar on his head. The Spirit of the Lord says, I was there when that happened. In fact, that I was there when it happened to every one of you. When the enemy abused and brought fists of fury. The Lord says that family is now being delivered from the forces of abuse. Says the Spirit of the Lord. Yeah! Come on, give it a shout of praise. Give the Lord a victory tonight. Come on, come on, give it a shout of victory tonight. Problem, or at least a colon problem that God is healing right now. A cancer. Wait, don't let the guy finish yet. Something else coming to me. Colon cancer or a colon, serious colon problem that God. You actually gave your son, didn't you? You gave your son, didn't you? No, no, not your brother. The Lord told me your brother. Okay, wait, hold on a second. Okay, keep praying with me, please. Okay, come stand proxy for please. Come stand proxy for you. I want the three of you to stand there. Three of you. Marcus is already here. There he is. Stay here. What are you praying for? Let's pray together. Come on, let's lift our hands. Come on. Michael? No, wait. Michael, who's Michael? Who are you praying for? Okay, okay. This is your son? Where is he right now? We just prayed for Michael, I'm sorry. Where is he right now? What are you praying for? No, 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 no. There's a father. Who's the father? See, I've seen his father. I've seen the powerful force of addiction that's there. God says they're not going to happen to Gilbert. God's healing the bruise and the antagonism that was brought against him. It's a young boy. God says, I'm changing the curse. I'm reversing the curse. Came through the Father, through the blood. God's going to break it now, tonight. Gilbert, we prophesy to you tonight. We say to you, just like Elisha said to the servant, those who are with you are far greater than those who are against you. The angel of the Lord is in your house. Where were you before you lived in this house? In an apartment. Something was brought from the apartment. A valuable piece was given to you. And God says, this thing, and I'm not one that takes pieces and then makes something out of them. Keep praying with me. Keep praying with me. But I'm seeing this thing. Caramito Sante di Volta Basi. Keep praying with me, please. Must tell her this, please, first. why he prophesies. Listen to me. I've seen this thing had influence and manipulation set on it. Just lift up your hands and praise me, please. Don't die now, okay? Because I'm digging deep now because I'm in her living room. I'm seeing your living room, dining room, connected. In the smaller room is the picture. You may not have to go and take the thing and throw it away. I'm not into that stuff. Although sometimes it's necessary. There's a tie being broken. Do you remember who gave that to you? Please pray with me. It's the curse. Those people don't like you. There are people in that family that don't like you. They don't like anything about you. Don't worry about that. Hey, God likes you. Who cares about them? Yeah, that's better. That's better. Who cares about them? Who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Come on. Who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Come on. Who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Come on, say it. Who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Come on. Who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Hey, anybody out there that has somebody that you're hurting about that doesn't like you, who cares about them? God likes you very, very much. Come on, say it. Who cares about them? God likes me very, very much. Come on. Who cares about them? God likes me very, very much. Come on. Who cares about them? God likes me very, very much. So I say to you, take the picture and throw it out. I'm serious. What is on the picture? Is it like the little animals or something? Okay. You like it? Throw it out then. Throw it out. Throw it out. Throw it out. I'm serious. Let's break the attachment. Are you married? You have no one now. Do you want somebody? God has somebody for you. You are not going to go, not going to have a repetition of four different divorces. You're not going to have a repetition. Somebody in your family went through a whole lot of divorces. It's not going to happen to you. God says, I'm going to give you a healthy relationship. You're going to be free. And the Lord says, I'm going to give you nicer pictures. I'm going to give you nicer in-laws. I'm going to set your body free. There's a miracle God's doing internally inside of you. There's a miracle happening right now. There are growths being removed. There is a miracle, a recreated miracle. The Lord says, take it! It's yours! Yes, yes, yes! Those points. Go your way, the Lord's touching. Come on, hallelujah. Are you praying for it as a child? Two sons? Your son? Four? Yeah, I'm four. I see four children. You four sons? No, four sons will all have the same authority. God's going to do the same thing in all of four of them. The one that's not there is going to get there very, very soon. Do you understand? The one that's not there is going to get there very, very soon. All four are going to be empowered. They're already, some of them are, but they're going to be greater power. God's anointed them, will not let them go until he has performed his work in them in the name of Jesus. Give the Lord praise. What are you praying for? Two boys? Who's Terry? Chris. Give me a few names as the Lord's just leading. Chris and Terry. I don't know who those people are, but that's what I got as I was standing here. Chris and Terry. Who are you? Chrissy, come here. Come on, let's give her a hand. Now, where's Terry? Terry? Arnold, don't think that I'm just messing around. I'm not. The Lord gave me a different... Terry Arnold, if you know this or know about this, let me know, okay? Chrissy. Okay, keep praying. Keep praying. What are you praying for? Two sons. One is away. Geographically away. They're both in the city. Are all your sons in the city? Your son, is he in the city? Now, let me tell you what I'm getting. There's somebody outside of the city. Some son that is outside of the city that needs a touch from the Lord right now. Can you come here quickly, sir? We're going to pray together now. Pray for your son. Where is he? There you go. They're going to come around. Don't worry. We know that. Where is he?
He's somewhere between Washington and the Gulf. We prayed for him 2 years ago.
Yes. Right. Where is he now? Between Washington and... Come stand here, please. The Spirit of the Lord wants to touch him now. Now. It's very desperate right now. Don't you dare give up. God says you... He's hanging on a thread. The thread is in you, says the Lord. Don't give up. I have not given up on him. I know exactly where he is. The Idaho potato. Keep praying with me, please. Right now, Lord. Where's Idaho? Where's Idaho?
Northwest.
North?
Northwest.
Northwest. I just saw the potatoes. I'm seeing something right now. Father, I pray that somehow, whatever the region means, whatever it's supposed to mean, I pray that you would do a miracle. The Lord has not given up. You don't give up. God says your words are going to be powerful. They're going to cause angelic confrontation with demonic powers and bring life where life has been stolen. I release a miracle right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't give up. God's going to do it and bring back with joy. Come on, give the Lord praise. Listen, what can we pray for? What can we pray for? What would you like to pray for? That's very kind of you. God gives me your name if you want me to pray for your sister. That's why he called you up. Because he said, I will honor your prayers. There will be a smile face on her face. God said, joy! And I will put laughter between the two of you. And then I will bring a spirit of joy upon the whole family. Because the Lord said, I'm laughing at the enemy that's trying to steal and destroy what I began in a life will be completed because you prayed. I have put a prophetic mantle upon you. I put a prophetic mantle upon you. That prophetic mantle will drive out anything that tries to steal from your family and your future is guarded by my spirit because I love you and I will not let you go until I've done what I said I do, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Lift up your hands. The Lord's presence is here right now. Keep praying with me, please. Keep praying with me. Hallelujah. Come on, keep praying with me. Keep praying with me right now. Come on, Osanto Namani, Tasso Namani. Come on, let's see everybody pray together. Father, we are praying now that every one of these women and men standing in front of me, anyone in this building that's representing somebody, I pray today, not only do I pray, but I prophesy that as you tap in to the word of the Lord, I will reach the unreachable, touch the untouchable, and I will defy the spirit that's trying to come against him. God says that will cause him to retaliate, but there will be a retaliation against the powers of darkness. He has a deliverance ministry, which I'll raise him up with, says the Lord. Give the Lord praise. I loose the anointing upon every one of you and set them free in the name of Jesus. They'll come around. Pray for a long situation with your nephew, niece. First cousin, come stand here, please. Hey, they called this week. Put your hands together. Come on, let's pray. Everybody lift your hands. I know you, it's time, it's late, but let's just pray. Come on, the Lord's doing something special in our midst. Father, we release. Give something to pay for. Come on, keep praying. Let's slow it down. Let's get some strings, please. I want the atmosphere to be filled with worship right now. Come on, let's pray together. As gentle as your soul is, as gentle as your worship is to me, says the Lord, I put a prophet at your feet to anoint your feet. The Spirit of the Lord says these feet will tread upon spiritual wickedness in this city. And I have lined up at this hour for punishment. You see, my son, the 12 were the big shots, but the 70 were the ones that aligned and set and lined up the demon powers to be trampled upon. You are one of the 70. Do not think this is a small thing. But as you agree with a prophetic word, as the 70 heard the words of Jesus, God said you will be one of those in this city that lines up demon powers, but you'll also be privileged enough to trample upon them, to trample upon them, says the Lord. For there's a righteous heritage of your family. Your heart has no evil in it. The Spirit is breaking your heart some more, and your feet are anointed, and you shall be a part of this great breakthrough. You will live with health. You will also, believe it or not, live with wealth. Because when this thing breaks, I remember your giving. I remember your praise. I remember your worship. I remember your dance that's made me laugh a lot of times with joy, says the Lord. I remember your song. I remember your praise. And your children shall have a double portion of what I give you tonight, says the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. I anoint you. Don't stop laboring. Don't stop. Now listen to me. The Spirit of the Lord says, I am by my Spirit right now releasing you to be a part of one of the greatest moves of the Spirit. It doesn't matter if anybody else doesn't believe it, I'm giving it to you. No, I'm not just giving you a nice word, for you will be a part of it. Why? Because you were there when I spoke my word over Denver. And the 70 that were there when I spoke over that area were privileged enough to trample. Don't you stop laboring. They labored, they walked, they worked, they preached, they prayed. But there came a change in the atmosphere when I prophesied over the city. And that change in the atmosphere gave them authority over demon powers. The change is taking place. I've not forgotten you as you've not forgotten me. I anoint you, I've appointed you, therefore get ready, for you shall rejoice greatly, for I will not let you go, as I have a covenant with you, and I will always send you my choice. I will send you prophets, apostles, teachers, evangelists, elders. I will raise up, and those that walk away, I'll add more, with more quality, with more power, because you are a special gem, a treasure to me that I will not forget, says the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise Him. Mary, and then the cloth. put on your head. Satan always wants to hide the real Mary, the real person. This cloth will never come on you again. You will never be oppressed, because now tonight you have a chance to tap in to the deliverance that is due to you. Come on, Mary. Don't think about your age, because you look 10 years younger than your real age. So forget that stupidity. The Spirit of the Lord right now says to you, I am removing any oppressions, and you will see yourself the way I see you. That which I have promised will happen. You are not rejected. I have put you, I put your gifting aside for a while. It will be resurrected at the right time, the right place, for the right reason. Keep worshiping me. Keep praising me. I love your songs. Don't give up. But the real person is about to come forth. The real Mary is about to come forth. You've overcome the battle. You've overcome the struggle. Now go with everything you've got, for you will never have the cloak of oppression ever cover your face again, says the Lord your God. Come on, give the Lord praise. Let's give the Lord a hand tonight.
Thank you so much for watching. And thank you for going back in time with me and having these incredible moments with my dad. You know, one thing about my dad is that he was one of a kind. And I'll tell you something, he is irreplaceable. And he was a precious and beautiful gift. And the passion of my heart is to put out there as much as I can of what he did. Because my father labored for 40 years. He traveled all over the world, to countries all over the world, all over the United States. And I have found in our archives some incredible, incredible moments that you have never seen. And so that's why I'm doing this. I'm sharing this because there are prophetic moments and words that, even though he said it years ago, are relevant right now for the time that we're living in. I'm so passionate about getting that out there, getting that to you to see these moments, to hear these insights. And in order to do that, I need your support too. And so if you're enjoying these prophetic rewinds, if you like traveling through time with me and seeing my father in the past, if this is blessing you and blessing your life, and especially we put these out on a Monday because I know that this is the beginning of your week, and I want you to be inspired as you go into your week, and that you have a prophetic mindset, a prophetic insight, something to drive you as you go through your week, because life is hard. Your support is an offering to God. It's an offering to God, and it also supports me in what I'm doing and trying to get as much of my dad out there and what he did and share it with the world. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart.